Hi, my name is Sulekha Chandra, founder of Gyan Paradise. Today I'm with Abhishek. Abhishek is a young entrepreneur and he has started his entrepreneurship journey soon after mechanical engineering. So Abhishek, welcome to this session.
Thank you so much, Sulekha.
Thank you so much. Please give a brief introduction about yourself.
About myself?
Yeah.
My name is Abhishek Singh. And I started my entrepreneurship journey 5 months post my graduation. And I did a job for 5 months. And after that, it was enough for me because I understood my aptitude is not the one for job. So I shifted my attention to the things that I loved doing in life, the things that I was passionate, and I did not have any experience in that, any of it. So I started gaining experience, and past 4 years have been my journey into having a lot of experiences in, with the things that I'm passionate about.
Great, Abhishek. I have one question.
Definitely.
We are shooting this video particularly for people who are aspiring entrepreneurs. I have met some people who are in their graduation final year and they want to sequence their dreams. They have many dreams. Yeah, all of us have many dreams, but they want to sequence it. And young, and you know, these graduates, they are facing an issue that while they're at their home and they discuss their career with their parents usually discourage them to take up, you know, entrepreneurship. Mm-hmm. They discourage them. To such people, what would you advise? Because I think you have, you know, experimented with various business patterns, you know. So what would be your advice to such people?
Yeah, so like first, I would suggest them not to get discouraged. Because initially, even I was a little afraid of offending my parents, obviously. But that was the scene till they did not know that I am serious about what I want to do. And I had to show that in my persistence. I had to show that beyond the abusing, beyond the mental torture, beyond all the Indian stereotypical things that happened to a student, I had to move beyond that. After the 5 months, the next 1 year, it was hell. I had to convince my parents each and every day that I really want to do this. And the reality was, even I did not know what I was doing.
So you were confused, yeah?
I was definitely confused.
You were confused. But you were trying out things.
But I was trying out things, yes. And they did discourage me from doing things because they are my well-wishers. What else they would do?
Okay.
They are my well-wishers.
Point to be noted.
Right? So according to them, their reality is that I should have a secure job. And for me, my reality was I had an urgency that this is the time I have. 3 years down the line, I will be of the age of marriage and then I'll have to anyways get a job if I'm not successful in the business.
So that has his heart, I will respect that. Okay.
So that is somewhere I began. But then along the line, people understood my vision. The more I shared my vision, the more my parents were able to see that. The more I established a line of communication. It was not easy. But once it happened, it continued.
So you say the persistence is the key here.
Absolutely.
Would you like to give us a glimpse of what all businesses you tried?
Most definitely. I have tried majorly digital marketing, then various things within digital marketing, which was right from coupons up to selling unbranded to branded to rebranded t-shirts, rebranded Ayurvedic products and sports goods. Beyond that, I have tried my hand at setting up myself. I have 2 firms right now, one of which is media marketing, public relations, and the second one is into chemicals, that is organic chemicals.
Wow.
So yeah, so we are still experimenting on the organic part because we want to enter a market where the organic segment is strong. But with the media marketing company, me and my partner Pooja, we have been going at it for the past 1.5 years and now we have a very good standing. Within 1.5 years, we have established ourselves from Vashi, where I am based out of,
to Narimon Point, where we had a dream of having an office.
That's incredible. That's incredible, and I really congratulate you for that.
Thank you.
Thank you, Abhishek, for sharing these insights. What else would you like to share? Anything from, you know, your perspective?
My perspective, especially for the young people, don't take life too seriously. Because there are paradigm shifts happening. Jobs are scanty. People have a lot of talents, but in the name of job, in the name of security, safety, they are being pushed into a net where they are just small fishes in a big pond.
Okay.
So, for most of them, it might not work out. So rather than pursuing things that are socially acceptable, they should rather focus on things which are personally viable.
Great.
Which they can be proud of doing, which they can take risks and feel fulfilled. Even if they fail hard, and they can be proud that I tried and I failed.
That's it.
Then there is always the option of going back to a job.
See, that's a great insight. That is always, it always remains at the back of our mind, I think so. Yeah, for entrepreneurs, they always think at the back of their mind, I can always take up a job, but why not try
what
I love to do? But why not give it a try?
So. Absolutely. I have myself failed at around the last thing I did 6 months back. After which I have continued with media marketing.
Mm-hmm.
That was my 7th experiment. That
okay. 7th experiment.
7th experiment. And after that I got my stability. In past 3 to 4 years, I have failed in around 6 to 7 things. And now I have my feet in the ground.
Now we have the feet in the ground. So we must say that after so much of experimentation, you have got ways which should be avoided.
Absolutely.
To get the business in place.
Absolutely.
And you have, you know, achieved it. Now you have an office in Nariman Point that itself says a lot of things, yeah? Thank you, Abhishek. Thanks a lot for being here. Thanks.
Thank you for having me here.
Thank you so much.